फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कोडिंग होस्ट यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल शो यू प्रोग्राम फॉर यूजिंग स्टैटिक मेथड्स इन जावा। टेक एन एग्जांपल, लेट आई हैव नंबर्स लाइक इंट ए इक्वल टू 10, इंट बी इक्वल टू 20 एंड इंट सी इक्वल टू 30। सो आई वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट द क्यूब ऑफ ईच नंबर एंड देन आई वॉन्ट टू एड द क्यूब ऑफ ऑल द नंबर्स। सो आई विल राइट इट लाइक दिस, ए इक्वल टू a into a into a and b equal to b into b into b and c is equal to c into c into c. So suppose if we have multiple variables, we have to write the same lines multiple times, a into a and b into b into b. So it will take lot of time, and after that we also have to use a line to add all these numbers. So what we can do is we can use static methods which will return us the cube of the number we are passing. We can later add the cubes we have got from static methods. So let's see how we can do it. So first I am removing this. So outside of our main method, I am making a new method, public static int cube, and inside this I will pass a parameter int n, and inside of this I will write return n into n into n. So it will return us the cube of the number we are passing to it. So static is the keyword for making a static method, and if we are not writing void keyword with static, that means that method is a static method and it will return a value. And if we are not writing return inside it, it will give us a error. And I have written here int. Int means it is the return type of our method, that it will return a int value. And cube is the name of our method. And int n is the parameter. It will take only one parameter. So let's see how we can use it in our main method. So here I will write cube, and inside of this I am writing a. After that I am using cube and I am writing b. After that I am again writing cube and I am passing c inside it. So you can see it will return us a number, but where we can store it. So I am writing like a equal to a cube, b equal to b, and c is equal to c cube c. And after that I will take a new variable, int sum is equal to a plus b plus c, and after that I will print it, sum of numbers is equal to sum. So let's run our program. So you can see we are getting 36,000. So I am using command to show cube of number. So cube of 10 is 1000, cube of 20 is 8000, and cube of 30 is 27,000. And when we add all these numbers, we will get 36,000. Let's see how this program is working. So I have written public class hello. So first our JVM will execute our class, and then our main method public static void main. So after that it will execute our variables a, b and c. So a, b and c variables will get space in the memory. So I am writing a, b and c, and the initial value of a, b and c is 10, 20 and 30. After that I have written a equal to cube a. So from here our program will go to our cube method, and it will take int n parameter, and in which we have passed a variable. So it will take the value of a, which is 10, and after that it will return n into n into n. So we have 10 in the n. So 10 into 10 into 10 is 1000. So we get here 1000. And after that, I have written a equal to cube a. So it will store that return value back to a. So now a has 1000 inside it. After that, it will execute b equal to cube b. So first it will call our cube b method, and I have passed b variable. So it will go to the cube method, and it will take the b as a parameter, and it will return us the cube of b, which is 20. And so it will go back to our program, and here we get 8000, and I am assigning that value back to b. So now we get 8000 in our b variable. After that, it will execute c equal to cube c. So I have passed c variable, and now it will go to our cube method, and it will take c variable as a parameter. So now int n has c inside it, and it will cube of variable c, and c has 30 inside it. So we will get here 27,000, and I am assigning back it to c. So now c has 27,000 inside it. After that, I have declared a variable int sum equal to a plus b plus c. So it will add the all these numbers, and it will store them back to some variable, and after that I am printing some variable, and we get 36,000 in our output. So you can see static methods are very important for us if we want to perform operations of variables, and we also want to get back value from our method for further use. So we can use static methods in that case, and we also have to use a return statement in our static methods, otherwise we will get an error. So this is how we can write a program for using static methods in Java. Thank you.